What can be more soothing than living in a city that floats? Probably nothing. Our world is on the lane of technology, and day after day, we are graced with newer and newer products of technological advancement, the latest of which is the Floating City Initiative. With the first prototype unveiled last year, Saudi Arabia has taken a bigger step towards making the concept a reality with their £6.8 billion floating Turtle City. What's this project about and what does it seem to cover? Let's find out in this video. The Floating Turtle City. It has been suggested that the huge yacht Pangaeos, which has the form of a turtle, be built in Saudi Arabia. The proposal, if realized, would result in the largest marine vessel ever built. Basically, a huge floating city. The term Pangaeos was sourced from Pangaea, a supercontinent that existed around 200 million years ago. The Lazzarini Design Studio created and put out the concept. The firm, which is located in Rome, uses 3D technology to depict designs and concepts. Pangaeos' planned dimensions are very enormous. The vessel would be the biggest thing ever built if it were built. The Seawise Giant, built by the Japanese company Sumitomo Heavy Industries, was the largest sea vessel ever built. It was 458.5 meters long. The current world's largest yacht is the German-made Azam, which measures 180.61 meters in length. Both of these titans will be dwarfed by the Pangaeos. Its projected measurements are 610 meters wide and 550 meters long. The enormous ship will serve as a floating city, having adequate room for public places like parks, retail malls, and hotels. According to Lazzarini, Pangaeos can hold 60,000 people, in addition to an undefined number of crew and personnel. There would be enough for 69 apartments and 19 villas on each side wing of Pangaeos. On the rooftop shell, 72 terraces will be offered. Some will overlook the central port area of the ship, while others will offer sea views. In contrast to a typical cruise ship or yacht, the Pangaeos would be the main attraction. The Pangaeos is anticipated to have a peak speed of only 5 knots, 5.7 miles per hour, 9.2 kilometers per hour, propelled by 9 16,800 horsepower HTS engines. The ship's leisurely, steady pace makes sense considering its enormous weight. Visitors may choose between using a different maritime vessel or an airplane to go from the Pangaeos to other areas. On board, a port for other vessels will be built, and an upper shell region will provide access for flying objects. The bows start at the port's main plaza and stretch through a long terraced villa before leading to individual residences, structures, and rooftop terraces. The design team's basement has 30,000 cells or cluster compartments and offers an unsinkable floating solution that is intended to be mostly constructed in steel. Pangaeos is a planned ship for Saudi Arabia, but due to its almost limitless supply of renewable energy, it is intended to cruise non-stop around the globe. Unsurprisingly, it won't be inexpensive to construct a huge floating metropolis. According to Lazzarini, the development of Pangaeos will need an expenditure of $8 billion. In order to raise money, there is an NFT crowdfunding project. Cryptocurrency may be used by backers to purchase virtual space on Pangaeos inside the metaverse. Construction, according to Lazzarini, would take 8 years. Finding a suitable location big enough for such a massive building project is difficult enough. Designers have chosen a site near King Abdullah Port as a potential location for the mega project, pending approval from the Saudi Arabian government. To start construction, a seabed area of around 1 square kilometer would need to be dredged. Water levels will be managed at the building site using a circular dam. Pangaeos is still very much in the conceptual stage right now. However, the futuristic floating city's development will someday start in Saudi Arabia. Busan Oceanics. Oceanics Busan, the first floating city prototype in the world, has been visualized. Off the coast of South Korea, the goal is to build a community that can accommodate increasing sea levels. According to Rose Dykins, UN Habitat, the Busan Metropolitan City of the Republic of Korea and blue tech design firm Oceanics have shown new drawings of a future sustainable floating city. Furthermore, it will soon become a reality when development gets underway next year. What is the purpose? With the climate catastrophe and significant land limitations in coastal towns, Oceanics Busan aims to provide a groundbreaking solution. 2 out of every 5 people on the planet live within 100 kilometers of a coastline, and 90% of megacities are at risk from sea level rise, which may result in billion-dollar flood damage to infrastructure and the eviction of millions of climate refugees. Residents are compelled to migrate closer to the sea in places with fast population growth, where there is limited opportunity for expansion, raising housing prices to perilous levels and displacing people with the lowest incomes. Cities on water might aid in our adaptation. Philip Hoffman, CEO of Oceanics, said, "Today is a pivotal milestone for all coastal cities and island nations on the front lines of climate change. We are on track to deliver Oceanics Busan and demonstrate that floating infrastructure can create new land for coastal cities looking for sustainable ways to expand onto the ocean while adapting to sea level rise." The world's top designers, engineers, and sustainability specialists collaborated to create the flood-proof prototype under the direction of New York-based Oceanics. The principal designers of Oceanics Busan, which was announced at the second UN Round Table on Sustainable Floating Cities, were the Big Bjark Ingalls Group and SAMU, owned by Samsung. The agreement to construct the prototype with a host city was formed during the first round table in 2019, and Busan was agreed to serve as that city in 2021. Busan was a logical place to use for the deployment of the floating city prototype due to its position on the southeast coast of South Korea, its maritime culture, and its well-established marine engineering sector. Busan's mayor, Park Hong-joon, has lofty plans to make Busan a smart, eco-friendly city and to submit a proposal to the host of World Expo in 2030. In response to sea level rise and its disastrous effects on coastal towns, he remarked, "We joined forces with UN Habitat and Oceanics to be the first to prototype and scale this bold notion." The executive director of UN Habitat, Maimuna Mould Sharif, remarked during the event, "We cannot handle today's challenges with yesterday's tools. We must come up with creative answers to the world's problems. However, let's be inclusive and fair in our pursuit of innovation and make sure we don't leave anybody or any location behind." Oceanics Busan, the first sustainable floating town prototype in the world, is made up of 15.5 acres of linked platforms that can house 12,000 residents with 30,000 to 40,000 square meters of mixed use area per platform. Each community is created to fulfill a distinct function, whether it be homes, research centers, or eco-friendly accommodation. The link span bridges that connect the floating platforms to the ground frame the protected blue lagoon of floating performance, art, and leisure venues. The low-rise structures feature rounded edges and terraces for living inside and outdoors, and they connect the Oceanics Busan's network of energetic public areas. The goal is for Oceanics Busan to naturally change and adapt throughout time in response to Busan's demands. It has the capacity to grow from a neighborhood of 12,000 inhabitants and guests to house more than 100,000 people. The prototype floating city relies on 6 interconnected systems to run smoothly: closed-loop water systems, closed-loop food systems, net-zero energy systems, innovative transportation, and coastal habitat regeneration. 100% of the city's energy will be produced by these interconnected systems through rooftop and floating photovoltaic panels. Each neighbourhood will also provide innovative urban agriculture, treat and replenish its own water supplies, conserve and recycle resources, and have outposts and greenhouses on the floating platforms. A template for resilient and sustainable communities, according to Big Bjark Ingels Group founder and creative director Bjark Ingels, will be Oceanic's modular marine city. Oceanic's Busan, our first example of this new type of waterborne urbanism, will transfer the city's distinctive personality and culture from the land to the surrounding waters. We think Oceanic's floating platforms may be produced in large quantities to act as the building blocks for future resilient settlements in the most vulnerable coastal regions on the front lines of climate change. Sustainability is built into floating city design. Sustainability is yet another crucial aspect of the design. To guarantee that the floating city reuses and wastes as little as possible, the Oceanic's Busan features 6 integrated systems that are focused on energy, food, water, trash, transportation, and coastal habitat regeneration. Photovoltaic panels on rooftops and floating structures will produce all of the city's operating energy requirements. Each community will have its own water treatment and replenishment system, resource reduction and recycling measures, and food production in urban farms. Overlooking the future. The proposal to build a floating metropolis is not limited to Busan. The carbon-neutral floating office Rotterdam, which can float with rising sea levels, was launched by King Wilhelm Alexander of the Netherlands in the Dutch port in September 2021. Maldives' floating city construction is also expected to get underway this year, with more than 80% of its land area at or below 1 meter above sea level. The archipelago in the Indian Ocean is one of the most climatically susceptible countries. While floating towns and offices are one way to mitigate the effects of climate change on coastal communities, the ocean still faces a number of other problems that need immediate attention. And with that, we come to the end of this episode. Did you like what you just watched? Then like the video and subscribe to our channel. See you again in the next one.